ourselves and get ourselves cracking here. We are with Coach Scott Peter and two of his players after the 60-7 win over Coastal Carolina, the Chanticleers, as they were. Coach, give us your breakdown on the game today.
I think we challenged the girls this week in a couple different areas. One was to play with a little bit more grit and tenacity, and I thought we did that today. And it really showed in the area of the draw that we cleaned that up. And I thought our midfield play of the draw, the ride, and the clear, that's what won us our game today.
This one started out with the looks of maybe being a blowout after you're 8-4 or 8-1, and then they scored the final three goals of the first half. Was that something you discussed at halftime?
We definitely went over that. That wasn't the way we wanted to go in the locker room. They got two in the last minute, and it was a little bit of a couple of breakdowns, but kudos to Coastal for making plays, to making a run at the end. Obviously, we'll have to fix that too to go in with a bigger lead.
Caroline, you were the leading scorer today. What were you seeing out there? How did you get there?
Well, my teammates cleared space for me, and I finally listening to coach and going down the lane and just finishing my shots.
Do you get tired of listening to Sweet Carolina after
you score
each other?
No, my mom really likes it.
You like to be here to play a lot, right? But the second half, obviously, you pulled away from them a little bit there, ended up scoring, I think, the final five goals of the game on them like that. Let's talk about the strategy at the end. What caused you to do that?
We made an adjustment on the offensive end, and I think we actually started on the defensive end by dialing up the pressure. That they started turning over the ball, trying to force the long pass, and we're getting overthrows, and that's from our girls getting out in their hands, making pressure. But then offensively, we spread them out a little bit, and then went to a different look that we really haven't shown too often. And it started with Jill Balog taking the ball behind at X and going hard and beating a girl 1v1. And we need to see more of that across the board of going hard and beating girls 1v1. And then right when that happened, it was just we got energized and everyone started wanting the ball and going hard.
Jill, with three goals today. Nice work by you.
Thank you.
You're a senior right now. You've been with this program a long time. Talk about the team right now, what you're seeing. How do you think this team is right now?
I mean, I think it's the most fun I've had all my years here. We just really mesh well together. We communicate better. It just flows way better. So it's just a lot more fun, and I think it's helping us on the field.
You're from Annandale, New Jersey?
Yeah.
Didn't Steely Dan write a song about that?
I don't know who that is.
I'm a lot older than you. Don't know who Steely Dan is. That's just morally depressing. Okay, Google that, would you?
I will.
Coach, as you look at this, you've actually had two pretty good defensive outlets the last two games. Butler did a really good job up there. Is the defense maybe coming around pretty quickly for you?
Yeah, we're starting to play our systems. We're understanding our systems and our tweaks of our systems back there on the defensive end. And really when it's taking the attacker out of their comfort zone, going out to make plays, and then really sending our doubles. And you've seen we had a lot of slides today coming from the area that we want to slide from. That Coastal, we sort of took them out of their game plan. We had a couple adjustments to make when they went to a high post. And we struggled with that a little bit, and then after the timeout, we made that adjustment. And then in the second half, it was almost like that we just dialed up the pressure. That it was more, and they just couldn't handle it with their stick skills. But they're a good team. It's their first game, obviously, as well too. So
this is a step out of Big East play for you all. It seems like you've been playing a lot of Big East schools lately. You jump back in that, do that next game, I think, against Vanderbilt.
Yes, Vanderbilt's a good team, and we're coming out a tough stretch for us. Three games in 6 days that we got to rest up in a hurry, get our scout in, and get the film in, and be better than we were today. And that will be the expectation for the team.
Julie, you did play against Vandy last year. Just what do you remember of them?
They are a quick team. They're all over the field. They play like midfielders, so they're quick. But I think we have quick midfielders and attackers, so I think we match them pretty well with that.
So there's your scout right there, Coach. All right. Carolyn, you're winning the scoring battle between you and your sister right now. Any bragging rights on that or anything?
No, she has a draw. I do goals. Like, we have our own thing. I think we all set each other, so pretty
good. People ever get you mixed up when they talk to you?
We don't look alike, but I think sometimes people mix up the name and the face. But overall, Coach doesn't mess up too much.
You'll have to ask Sarah what happened to Caroline's penny.
We'll have to get that one in next game then. Coach, things you take out of this as you prepare for Vanderbilt?
We're getting better. We're challenging the girls to be better every day, and I think every time that we step on the field, that we're getting better as a program. We're starting to understand our systems and fine-tune our systems, and really, really play the style of play that myself and my staff want to play. And it was just it's coming in when the coaching staff did come in. We threw a lot at the girls, and we're just starting to fine-tune it and figure things out.
Julie, maybe you can talk about that a little bit more. Obviously, it's a new system for you. You've been here for a while. This coach got a pretty good system working here. Is the one you're getting used to?
Yeah, we actually had a meeting earlier this week about me on defense, but he called it the teeter way, right? The teeter way of lacrosse. And it is a lot different, but it makes more sense to me. Like, we went over film, and the whole system on attack, it gives everybody an opportunity to score. On defense, it's really all about, like, teamwork, whereas it's not individuals anymore, which is why I think when we're on, we're on.
Well, there you have it, one of them Blaylock sisters and a girl from Annandale. Louisville wins 16-7.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks.